What's up, guys? Austin from Training Tall back with, well, not another video, but a podcast. Welcome to the first episode of what I'm going to call the Push Pace Podcast. And this is essentially going to serve as a platform for me to talk with you and hopefully at some point with others about, you know, what it means to push ourselves towards a better and happier us. And, you know, we can talk about anything, really. For those of you who don't really know who I am, my name's Austin. Over the last few years, I have been growing social media followings on YouTube and Instagram, providing content, information, and what some consider inspiration for a lot of different things, fitness. I started things off focusing on rowing fitness and really helping people understand how to use the rowing machine to better their fitness. I was a four-year collegiate rowing athlete. And so once I graduated college with a degree in exercise science, and I knew I loved making videos, I decided to start filling YouTube with rowing machine content. And since then, it's blossomed into many different things, whether that's covering my own training, my lifestyle as a 6'8" tall vegan who eats close to 6,000 calories a day, and, you know, just spreading out my passion for fitness into other things other than rowing. I've been a coach for Orange Theory Fitness now for, it's going to be 3 years in December, which is super exciting. It's kind of crazy how fast time flies, but a lot of you know me from my Orange Theory videos. I create daily workout tip videos for the daily Orange Theory workout. And so over the past few years, just it's been great to grow and hear from so many different people from around the world, whether that's about rowing or vegan nutrition or about Orange Theory stuff. And I figured this would be a great platform for us to talk in a more sort of casual way, covering different topics and things of interest. Let us really go into the details of whatever it is we really want to talk about. So that's kind of a little bit about me and what I'm hoping this podcast will be. You know, the idea of a push pace, this is kind of a playoff of Orange Theory. A push, something that is uncomfortable and challenging, and this push towards a better and happier us, a better, happier you and me, you know, really comes from getting uncomfortable and doing stuff that sort of takes us out of those comfort zones in whatever aspect that might be, whether it's business, you know, just life, family stuff, sports, you know, it can be anything. So in today's first podcast, I don't know how long this is going to be, but what I want to talk about is why pushing positivity really matters. And, you know, one thing that I am just so unbelievably grateful for is that I've been able to grow a following of people that have really shown immense amounts of positivity and inspiration for me, or towards me. You know, I'm very happy that I can provide you know, information, motivation for you guys, but to really see the positive feedback from what you guys say and the different accomplishments that you guys have, whether you're sending through a DM about your new rowing PR or just a comment on a YouTube video or an Instagram post. I'm very thankful, because on the internet, as I'm sure a lot of you guys know, it can be a very negative and toxic place. And the internet tends to bring out the true reality of people. And why pushing positivity matters is because we just got to face it. Like, right now, currently in the world we live in, it's just a very negative world. And that's not just on social media or the internet. It's, you know, a lot of us end up getting trapped into a daily lifestyle of, you know, just a lot of unhappiness and negativity. And, you know, it really comes down to this idea that attitude is everything. I mean, it, like, you know, just being mindful of how you feel in the moment and that you're in charge of how you choose to feel is such a powerful thing. But man, is it freaking tough to stay positive in a lot of situations, and especially when you realize, like, wow, I'm being a poopy pants negative person right now. And what can I do to change that? You know, because we can use a lot of excuses, a lot of, you know, circumstances that might have created this negative attitude. But when we walk around with a negative attitude on a day-to-day basis, all of a sudden that just becomes our norm. And when negativity becomes the norm, it becomes desperately harder and harder to dig ourselves out of that negative hole. And positivity and, you know, mindfulness of, you know, just doing our best to be more positive. I don't really know how to word it, and I'm so used to being able to clip video edits that sometimes, you know, as these words just flow out, I'll just stop talking and then try it again and edit it out. But I'm gonna try to keep this as free form as possible. An example I like to think about is, you know, think about, like, do you go get coffee in the morning? Like, do you go to a Starbucks or a Pete's Coffee or a Dutch Bros or wherever you go? Like, when you go to order your coffee in the morning, you know, do you just tell the barista, I want this, okay, oh, thanks, bye. You would be shocked at the brightness and light that can light up a barista's mood by just genuinely saying, hi, how's it going? Or hi, how are you today? In a way that's not just like a, how's it going? You know, like the usual, like just the casual blah, blah, blah convo. I challenge you to just, like, in that moment, try to care about, like, how they're doing and hear what they have to say, whether they just use a one word sentence or maybe a couple words. And whatever they say back to you, instead of just immediately saying good, because you're expecting them to say it back to you, you know, acknowledge what they say, or maybe wish them a good day after you get your coffee. Little gestures like that can totally make someone's entire day. And not only would that make someone else's day, you know, there's a sense of like gratitude and positivity within yourself that you get by, you know, being nice to other people or being positive around other people. And I know it's tough to do, and it's tough to, like, even, like, sometimes even just show a little care about someone that you don't even know. But you'd be shocked at how far that can take someone's attitude for the rest of the day. And positivity spreads like crazy, you know, because if you lighten someone's day for one moment, they might lighten someone else's day for a moment. Or, you know, if that barista is going to see 20 more people, what if they ask 10 of those people, you know, how they're doing, and they show a genuine concern? You know, it can just spread like wildfire. And it all comes from being mindful of what our attitude is and knowing that we are in control of every moment. You know, one thing I talk to a lot of my, you know, the members at Orange Theory or people online with is we just get so caught up in, like, the moment as it is of, like, I'm not where I want to be right now. This moment right now sucks, blah, blah, blah. And it's just one of those things where, like, literally every second that goes by, the past is in the past. Like, the past happened. There is nothing you can do about it. You might have been a poopy pants person for the last 30 years of your life. You can change that literally right now. You can change that tomorrow morning. It's unbelievable, unfathomable almost, how, you know, the ability of us in this day and age to just forget our past self and just start anew. Just take one small step towards a new us with a more positive and bright outlook towards the life ahead of us. Because you know what? I know I'm only 25. I know I'm not an older person. And honestly, like, that's definitely one of my, like, setbacks when it comes to giving fitness advice, is because a lot of people just be like, you know, Austin, you're just young. You have the energy now. Like, I'm really looking forward to being older. I mean, obviously I don't want to be older right now, but my point is, like, you just have so much time ahead of you. It's not even funny. Like, we think about the rate at which technology and medicine innovation is happening in this day and age. Like, you know, 15 years ago, we weren't holding smartphones at all. And it's like, now we are. And it's just crazy how fast technology and medicine advances. Everyone who is alive right now, you know, if you're 50 years old, realistically, maybe you're at halftime. Maybe you're halfway through your life. Just maybe you have at least 50 more years to go. You can't be throwing in the towel at, I think about myself at 25, sometimes getting in these thoughts of like, crap, like I'm not exactly where I want to be right now. I don't have the fancy place, the fancy car, and the family yet. And it's like, at 25, I've got at least four more of these 25-year chunks. If you're 70 years old, you're hanging and banging for 30 more years, most likely. 30 more. It's just an unfathomable amount of time to figure ourselves out. And that's why I truly push with a passion small changes day to day. Mindfulness of attitude and gratitude and knowing that, you know what? You got your whole life to figure things out. And if you can make one small change today, one small shift in your attitude, one, hey, genuinely, hey, how's it going? How's your day going? Or thank you so much for the coffee. Have a wonderful rest of your day. Just small little things day to day. They truly add up to something truly amazing. And so you don't have to push all this positivity all at once. You know, that's the theme of kind of this last like few minutes that I've been talking about, that it's not an all at once deal. It's just being mindful that a positive attitude and small shifts added up over time make a huge difference, not only to your own mindset, but to the positive influence that can have on so many other people. And that's why in my videos, like, I don't talk crap about people. I don't try to, bash things too negatively. I always try to keep a positive spin on things, understanding that positivity is where it's at in everything that we do. So my goal with this podcast and all the content that I create for you guys, whether that's on video format, on Instagram or YouTube or in the comments, my mission with you is to push positivity together, because we truly can make a difference. And I wholeheartedly believe that. There's so many people in the world. There's so many things going against being positive because it's so freaking easy to be negative. Oh my, can we just talk about that for a moment? How easy it is to be in a bad mood. You hardly need anything to set you off. You just need to stub your toe, your little pinky toe, on the edge of the table one time, and you can be in a pissed off mood for the rest of the day. Like, that's so easy to do, but to actively take charge and be positive, that's way harder. But you know what? That is why we're pushing. You have to push against the negativity, and it's uncomfortable. It is. It's tough. It's challenging. That's the point of the push. It's about the grind. Nothing, honestly, is better than pushing against the odds when they're stacked up against you. And right now, the odds are stacked against positivity. But you and I, together, we can push this thing forward. And that's what I am just stoked to do. Whether it's the, whether it's in videos or this or whatever it might be, but it can't just be a one person thing. It's not just going to be on me. It's going to be on you too. And I'm going to do whatever I can in my power to help push you towards positivity. But I want you to be mindful every day that you can. Just do your best, forget the rest. Tony Horton, he's my idol. And that's like the best saying in the world. What is it? There is no try. I disagree. Like, I 100% disagree that we can try. It doesn't have to be successful. But if you're mindful of action and trying to do something, whether it works out or not, that is monumentally better than just accepting the fact that things are poopy and there's nothing you can do about it. Because there's always something we can do about it. So I'm really excited. That's kind of the little chat for today. Pushing positivity matters, and we're going to do this thing together. That's kind of all I got to say for today's first Push Pace podcast. This is going to be a weekly podcast, at least to start. Hopefully, things can get more frequent. And I want to go into deep, deep detail on anything you guys want to hear, whether we want to go super hardcore and talk shop about rowing technique or, vegan lifestyle or Orange Theory workouts, benchmarks. Like, let's get down and dirty into whatever you guys want to talk about. I'm open for it. So let me know what you guys want to think. I want to hear your feedback on this. Hopefully this is a medium that you guys enjoy, and hopefully it can grow to something awesome, something that we can, again, push ourselves towards a better and happier us. So I want to thank you guys so much for joining me on the first Push Pace podcast. Be sure to, if you're not already, follow me on Instagram and YouTube, LinkedIn, Twitter, all at Training Tall. Be putting out content for you guys every day, the most best that I can. And let's keep pushing positivity together. All right, guys, I will see you in the next video. I always say that at the end of my videos. I will see you guys in the next Push Pace podcast, or when I see you next. You guys have a freaking amazing day. See you next time.